Hey guys, welcome back. So I tried to record this and somehow or another the fraps messed up and I ended up with just a partial unreadable file. So we're going to redo this. So we're back here in the Forbidden Oasis. We are working on Forbidden Oasis. Where are you at? Forbidden Oasis. I don't know why it does that. I guess the quest doesn't show up here. I wonder where the quest shows up. I'm not sure where the quest shows up. We've got this shard temple here, and we opened up the front door with some shards, and I went around and gathered up all the shards in the Forbidden Oasis so that we can open up more of the doors. So let's go and open up some doors. It took me a good 2 hours, maybe 3 hours of actual gameplay time to gather up all the shards from this zone, which is a massive pain in the ass. There's no reason why that it should be so difficult, especially in this zone where there's overhangs and walks and ladders, and it's just terrible. So here we are at the door. Let's go ahead and open her up. Yeah, so that's what I found the last time, right? So it says the door requires more shards than what you are carrying. And I collected all the shards. There are no more shards. I had 12, 15 shards, I think, from this zone. And it won't let me open. So I'm only can assume that you have to collect all the shards from all the zones to go through this temple. Temple of Pride, I guess it's called, which is ridiculous that you have to do that. So I'm not going to be able to do this quest because some of the zones I'm not high enough level to go in and collect all the shards at. So let's go back to Skyhold and we'll pick up a new quest.
Who said that?
Okay, so we're here in Skyhold. I still haven't talked to any of my inner circle, I guess they're called. So let's go and talk to Cassandra, because I think I'm going to do the romance quest for her on this run-through.
Have you met this friend of Varric's, Inquisitor?
Not yet, no.
It had better not be who I think it is. I will wring that little bastard's neck.
Who do you think it is?
Why? Who do you think it is?
Someone Varric claimed he could not contact. Someone the Inquisition, indeed all of Thedas, desperately needed. I'll reserve judgment until I know for certain. No need to have that rogue screaming persecution yet again.
All right, let's run through our conversational things. Tell me about yourself.
I'd like to get to know you better.
You would?
Is that a problem?
Not entirely. I'm just curious as to your motivation.
Like us to be closer.
Is there any harm in us becoming a little closer?
Plenty.
Is that right?
As you wish. My name is Cassandra Pentagast, daughter of the Royal House of Navarra, 78th in line for the Navarran throne. I joined the Seekers of Truth as a young woman, and was with the Order until they withdrew from the Chantry. I remained as the Divine's right hand, carrying out her order to form the Inquisition. And here we are. That's all there is to know, my lord.
Let's see about her royalty status.
You're a member of Navarra's royal family.
The Pentagasts are a very large clan. Half of Cumberland could say the same.
Really?
No, but it feels that way. I have hundreds of relatives so distant they need charts to prove we're related at all. And they have them. Oh, yes. The Pentagasts value their precious blood like it runs with gold.
She doesn't sound like she's on good terms.
You're not on very good terms with your family, then.
I do not visit, if that's what you mean. The Pentagasts are famed for dragon hunting, but few actually pursue the craft. Most are fat and lazy. They pay lip service to the Maker and care only for idle pleasures and past glories. My brother was all that kept me in Navarra. Once he was gone, so was I.
What happened to your brother?
Tell me about your brother.
I would prefer not to speak of Anthony. Another time, perhaps.
Though you brought him up. All right, tell me about your homeland.
You don't seem to like your homeland much.
My family polluted it for me. What little I saw of my homeland was through the bars of a gilded cage. My uncle treated me like a porcelain doll to be placed on a shelf and dusted only when necessary. Thus, I did not see Navarra, the real Navarra, until much later. By then, I realized I knew it not at all.
What about your parents?
Your uncle? What about your parents?
They had the misfortune of taking the wrong side in the second attempt to overthrow King Marcus. The king executed them, but spared my brother and I since we were family and children at the time. Thus, we were raised by my uncle, a Mortalitasi who preferred the company of his corpses to the living.
Mortalitasi didn't sound good.
Your uncle was a Mortalitasi?
A death mage. He still is. My countrymen do not burn the dead. They bury them in special crypts. The Mortalitasi supervise the crypts, like priests. Uncle Vestalus oversees the Grand Necropolis. Navarans spend more time honoring dead relatives than they do with living ones. It is odd to be so fascinated with death and its trappings. I will never understand it.
You work for the Divine?
So you were the right hand to the Divine?
To Divine Justinia, yes. And Divine Beatrix before her, in fact. The position is normally reserved for Templars of the Knights Divine, but my circumstances were unusual.
Unusual how?
You don't know the story? Thank the Maker. I will tell you if you wish, but it isn't as exciting as some drum it up to be. The short version is that I once saved the previous Divine's life. My reward was becoming her right hand.
What is a right hand?
But what does a right hand do exactly?
What is your hand capable of? It gives, it takes, it beckons. It makes a fist. Liliana and I extended the Divine's reach beyond the Grand Cathedral. We went where she could not. After Beatrix, I was tired of the position and wanted to return to the Seekers. But Justinia convinced me to stay. Her vision for the future gave me hope.
You believed in her?
You thought she could really change things?
Justinia knew the war was coming long before it began. She tried to avert it, but the forces arrayed against her were too strong. Sometimes you have to break a bone so it can be reset. That's where the Inquisition comes in. It was to be the answer. A means to preserve as well as an agent for change. I only wish she had lived to see it.
How do you become a right hand?
So what's the story about you becoming the right hand?
Sweet Andraste, do you really want to hear that? It was, what, 18, 20 years ago? Some still discuss it like it happened yesterday. The tale gets bigger each time it's told. I barely recognize myself within it now.
You're being modest.
I'm sure you're just being modest.
I was there. I think I know what happened. To hear others tell it, I alone saved Divine Beatrix from a horde of dragons sent to assault the Grand Cathedral. Rather impressive for such a young seeker, wouldn't you say?
And the truth is?
I stumbled upon a conspiracy to kill Beatrix. A Templar Knight Commander was at its heart. And there was a dragon battle at the Grand Cathedral. But I had help from loyal mages who rallied to the cause. They freed the dragons from magical control. Without them, the Divine and I would both have died. Yet I became the right hand, and they are forgotten.
I think the delightful one shows hearts, yep.
You're delightful, you know that?
No, I do not know that.
Mm-hmm.
I object. There is nothing delightful about me.
I beg to differ.
Who could have guessed the Inquisitor would be so odd?
That's all.
I'll let you get back to work.
All right. Cool, cool, cool. All right. Let's go up to the war table.
Lots of standards. That'll guide the dragon right in.
Well, when a mommy demon and a daddy demon really love each other, alright, so let's collect up some of these quests that we had going on. False accusations. Lady Dahlia's daughter did far more than sympathize with the mage's plight. Her former lover is a mage with extremist tendencies, at that. This mage and his associates are stirring up anti-Templar sentiment to discredit the Inquisition. He fears our association with the Templars grants them too much power, posing a significant threat to what remains of the mage rebellion. Fortunately, Lady Dahlia has agreed to quiet the accusations against our Templars, provided we keep her daughter's indiscretions a secret. Sure. Shadows over Denerim. Well, that was bracing. A pitched battle with evil mages disguised as kitchen servants, fireballs flying and swords flashing. It brings back old times. I won't be eating anything coming out of those kitchens for a while, let me tell you. I wonder if they are going to poison me. Nasty little cultists. Anyhow, I'm grateful for the Inquisition's help. We wouldn't have found them without you. King Alistair Therin.
Alistair, we cannot neglect our soldiers' training.
Can we neglect roads? Our allies cannot take the same route through the mountains we did.
Conscript for the Inquisition. We've gained access to a number of private libraries and archives. No information on Corypheus, unfortunately. However, we did find this fascinating treatise, which is a schematic for a round pommel. Okay, so let's send our agents out. Arl of Redcliffe, confront the mages in the Wending Wood. A dangerous cell of rebel mages have been tracked to a remote location in the Wending Wood. They are known enemies of the Inquisition and its allies. These men and women pose a significant danger to those traveling along the Pilgrim's Path between Denerim and Armanthian. They are directly responsible for the death of 7 mages and a noblewoman's daughter. The Inquisition's Templars are prepared to defend against this threat. All right, Cullen, go take care of them. So let's see. What else have we got? Gather coin. Specializations. I can ensure instruction for the legions who want to join, but we can expect the Inquisitor to remain a leader while training with the subordinate. He is a figure of inspiration and should rightly be one of the aspiration. Promoting a specialist from within the ranks seems lacking. With due respect to our people, the needs of the Herald are so specific, I recommend looking outside for the best combat specialist to be found, regardless of their affiliation. So Liliana
Inquisitor
goes out and finds people. The best of the best have been summoned. Training with these specialists will ensure the Inquisitor's abilities remain at their height. So this is how we get our specializations. Let's see. Reports of Darkspawn activity. Reports of Darkspawn activity on the Storm Coast. While the area is sparsely populated, the Darkspawn pose a significant threat to travelers as well as to Inquisition soldiers stationed on the coast. Should the Darkspawn branch away from the region, villagers further inland may be at risk. How can we send Cullen? I thought he was on another duty. Oh, maybe he... That's weird. Alright, well, let's send Cullen's men out. It's only going to take 9 minutes. I thought he was over here. Confronting mages in the Wending Wood. That's weird. Alright, search for the Hack Rider. Gathering resources. Truth or Dare. Madam Ambassador, words cannot express my gratitude for your gracious hospitality at Skyhold. After the events at Haven, one can hardly go anywhere in the Empire without hearing the word Inquisition. I shall be glad to have some facts to add to the wild rumors. I am as grieved as you to hear of the vicious slander being spread. Justinia V was the best of us. It pains me to think that others would pollute her legacy in such a manner. I travel to Valforay soon. I shall ensure my cousins know of the truth of this matter. Now that he's been here, we should talk to the nobles he's been seen with and let them all know.
Inquisitor.
Right. Ooh, that's a 3-hour one. Alrighty then. So we got that taken care of. Got no quests over here, so let's go over to Orlais and see what we've got going on. So, I can investigate the Western Approach, which, if it's got this thing over top of it, Flames of the Inquisition Charger. I wonder what that is. Oh, we have garnered the attention of the finest armorers in the land, and they would not see our message conveyed unadorned. They offer a mount that reflects the flames of the Inquisition. It is, by all accounts, magnificent. A block letter note that follows. We would send you our best, and you will know when you see it. It is as much at home in the parade as it is on the battlefield. Let all who stand against you see that they stand against a force, a cause. Our skill is yours. All right. Cool. Now we have another horse. Inquisition Barded Charger. Cool. I thought that was its little flamey thing, but I guess it was the thing behind it. A little flamey thing, I think, connects up to this. Investigate the Western Approach, which is a quest in a zone. And I wish that they would tell us what the levels. Like, see, Empress du Lion is 20, so you've got to assume that it is a higher level than something that requires 8. So we've got 2 20s. And 3/8. I don't think I've got any agents left. Oh, I guess I've got Liliana. Send an agent to eliminate the advisor. Inquisition agents have uncovered a potential problem in the nation of Navarra. A Deventer mage by the name of Aurelius has recently been noted in the company of King Marcus, and rumors comment on how strange it is for a new advisor to be closely heeded. There is evidence to indicate Aurelius is a member of the Venatari. Having the Navarran king under their sway would give the cult a great deal of power and hinder the Inquisition's ability to operate in the north. So, sounds like a good
task.
Let's
see what we have.
For Liliana to see what we have. Okay, so now all of our agents are out. So, I'm thinking I want to do make contact in the Emerald Graves, because it's a cost of 8, which should be right up our alley. We've been contacted by a Fairbanks who says he has information of value to the Inquisition. He offers a trade, the information in exchange for the Inquisition's help in eliminating a dangerous rebel band calling themselves the Freemen of the Dales. There have been reported sightings of these rebels all over the Dales, where they have caused significant problems for Orlesian troops. Uprooting them could be a good move for us. So Liliana thinks we should take these guys out. First, let us see what Fairbanks has to say. He is hiding out somewhere in the Emerald Graves, a legendary Dalish forest. My spies report that he is well acquainted with the area and its terrain. He could prove a useful asset if we choose to trust him. All right, let's head out. New area unlocked. Lead Scout Harding made contact with Fairbanks and his men in the Emerald Graves and had a run-in with the rebel Freemen of the Dales. They're as violent as we've been led to believe. As for Fairbanks, Harding was unable to coax much from him. He will only share what he knows with the Herald of Andraste, it seems. Well, of course he will, otherwise we wouldn't have a game or a quest or anything. Fairbanks is holding his information close to his chest. I wonder if it might relate to something bigger than just the Freemen of the Dales. If there is a chance at all, then we must learn all we can from him. Harding has set up an outpost in the Emerald of Graves. Be careful, Inquisitor. The Forest of the Graves is treacherous and home to enemies both new and ancient. Venture forth. Who do we want to take? Alright, so we don't need another scout. Certainly not another 2 archers, because that's already what I am. Cole, I don't have him yet. I need to go and speak with him around to get him. So I haven't recruited him yet, I guess is what I'm saying. We got Vivienne, Solas, Iron Bull. Alright, so we definitely want a mage. So let's bring Vivienne, and let's bring Iron Bull and Cassandra. That could be fun.
Good to see you again, Inquisitor. Hope you've got your comfortable boots on. The scouts have seen a number of fade rifts all over the forest. We've located this mysterious Fairbanks. He won't share his information with anyone but you. He and his men are camped out at Watcher's Reach, on the path ahead. From what we can tell, they're refugees from the war. Peasants, mostly.
A little flirty action. You can't romance Harding, but you can flirt with her.
I do enjoy these encounters. It's like we're getting to know each other.
We are, aren't we? Such a shame our meetings are so brief. But, you know, saving the world and all that. Busy, busy.
Tell me about Fairbanks.
Tell me everything you know about Fairbanks.
We don't know much about him. He appeared after the Civil War started, helping people fleeing from the destruction. Fairbanks is likely not his real name.
No kidding.
Do you know anything else about the region?
They call this place the Emerald Graves. Legend says that a tree grows here for every elven knight of Halam Shiral who perished in its defense. Makes you sad, doesn't it?
Don't let it bother me.
Thedas is soaked in blood. If I worried about those who've died in every place I went, I'd be a sobbing mess.
That's one way of thinking about it.
That's right, baby. I'm a hard ass.
Thank you for the information. I'll head out.
One other thing. A group of deserters from the Imperial armies has established itself here. Freemen of the Dales, they call themselves. They are hostile to the Inquisition and everyone else. Watch your back, Inquisitor.
You betcha, baby. Alright. We got Iron Bowl needs an upgrade, so let's take a look at what he's got going on. Ooh, 2 points for him. Alright. I think we were working on two-handed. So, we could... Flames erupt from the fissure left by Earth-shaking strike. Oh, that's pretty damn cool. Guard Smasher, Whirlwind. Alright, I gotta see Flames. That's just too cool. So then I'm gonna start applying points to his Reaver skills. Ring of Pain. Bring it on! Okay. So, I did some equipment mucking about. Here, I'll go claim this. That's pretty easy. Alright, I did some equipment mucking about off camera because it takes so long. It's really not worth being on camera for that. So let me just show you what everybody's sporting now. So, main character here, I made a dragon longbow and put my grip on it and crafted a rune for it. And I believe all the rest of the gear is the same. He's using a superior hunter mail that I found, and then I put some arms and legs on it. And let's see here, Vivienne. We're still missing some accessories for her. We need a belt and another ring, and the ring that she has is pretty lame, and the amulet she has is pretty lame. It doesn't really... I only have it on her because I have it and nothing else, so constitution really isn't something a mage needs. She's using the imbued enduring rod that I made. I don't have any rune on it, but we've got an imbued staff grip and an innate staff blade, and she's wearing a fade walker freezing enchanter coat, which I made. It's actually pretty nice, to be quite honest with you. I think it looks pretty good too. She's got all these like metally shoulder pads. That's like uber 80s style right there. Iron Bull, haven't really done much with him. I think he's still rocking his regular, yes, he's his primate, his weapon that he came with. He's got some Vanguard mail that we made. Heavy common, I don't think, no, that's not made. It's just the arms and the legs that I made. And then a Blight Wasp, no, a Rash Vine, Vitar. So, but he's got some pretty decent rings, so that's okay. And then Cassandra, we really decked her out. Check this out. That's pretty fancy sword. I like spent a lot of good materials on that sword. I kind of wish the shield had a red thing going on, but it doesn't. and I kind of wish I could have gotten the helmet color to match the metal, but it doesn't. So she's a mishmash. Rainbow. Orange, red, and blue. Anyways, her sword is a brutal berserker broadsword that is pretty damn cool. I used a Mastercraft item when I made this, and we found this, and I threw it on her because it was just so good. And then the Orlesian Lion Shield is a found item. I did make this hat, which is just a crafted helmet with 60 maximum health. I do wish I had a better amulet for her, again with just a +2 constitution, but she's got a decent belt. +100 maximum health is always good for your main tank, and then she's got the two rings. So that's what we're rocking for equipment. So it looks like we need to head north. And we've already got bad guys. Look at that. Starting right off with the bad guys. Try to catch some high ground up here. So I wonder if I do this in poison. Maybe catch him. Nice. Whoop, he fell down. Stand up. There you go. Where are you guys? I was really hoping for a hanging back. Alright, so let's see if I do this. It'll go through him. Yeah. That's cool. Whoops. Damn, they're all down. Well, Iron Bull, you are a wuss. I guess that big red circly thing was his circle of pain or whatever it's called. Alright. What? Deep mushroom, yeah. I'm not picking any more deep mushrooms. I've got more than enough mushrooms to make 100 pizzas. Ooh, what do we have here?
Fairbanks is expecting you at the camp.
At the camp.
I'd like to trust you, but we don't trust anyone these days.
These days. Rashvine. That can't be good stuff. Something called Rashvine. Not good. But I don't have any, so, you know. If it's there, probably ought to get some as I'm walking by. It's not anything out of my way.
You have it. Of course not.
Oh. Okay, Fairbanks. Here, Fairbanks.
It is an honor to meet the Herald of Andraste.
Everything you hoped for?
I hope I don't disappoint.
Not at all. But as they say, actions speak louder. As my missive stated, we can help each other. You have encountered the Freemen. Aggressive bastards, no? They've killed a dozen of my people. We've tried to fight, but we cannot match their strength. You can. Why should you care about this, you ask? Because the free men are colluding with your enemy.
My enemy?
Which enemy do you mean?
The rogue Templars. I've seen them through the woods, heading for the free men bases, leaving with crates. Destroy the free men, and they'll lead you straight to the red Templars. This I promise.
Well, Liliana says we want to do it, so we'll do it.
I'll look into this, Fairbanks.
All my information about the free men is right here, in our camp. Help us. And everything I know about the Dales, about these woods, I will share with the Inquisition.
Oh, isn't that just nice? Alright. Watchers reach refugees. Examine Fairbanks' documents. Where are the documents? Oh shit, that was easy. Huh, I don't think that was it. But I think maybe this was it. Here we go. Okay. More Veilfire. Well, at least we know where to get it. Let's see, what do we got over here? Anything good? Some pretty sad little shacks, though. Ooh, bedtime story. Watch, it's going to be the Rowdy Dowager. Nope. The Randy Dowager, that's it, not Rowdy. Randy. Clara.
I'm sorry. I'm not in the mood to talk right now.
Well, then why do you have a talkie bubble? See a wolf? I don't see a wolf. Nope. Don't see a wolf.
I can't believe he's making us hide out here like mice.
Take. Ooh, look. Watcher's Pass. It's a treasure map. Shh, don't tell anybody. We took your treasure map.
Hush. It'll all be better.
But what if it's not? What are you going to say then? Seems like empty promises to me. Ooh, energize. Energize me. Oh. Alright. I don't want that. There we go. Now I don't have it.
And what did they need? All's well, it seems. We shall see.
We shall see. Alright. So, map. What do we got? Fallen Sister, Holding the Graves. We've got a rift over here at the cove. Rift. Alright, let's head north. Make way for camp. Climb. Interesting. Let's see where this brings us. Seeing anything up here. Oh. There we go. Cool. I'm not sure that was worth it, but... Oh, that was a fall. Might as well pick up the ore while we run past.
Keep your hands and weapons to yourself.
Aren't you a little messy? Okay. So I'm going to try to make it to this camp over here.
You know, Viv, you're not bad with that stuff.
You will address me as Enchanter Vivienne, court mage to the Empire of Orlais, or Madame de Fer, not Viv.
Oh, right. Ma'am. Sorry. Ma'am.
Yes. Ma'am works as well.
Oh-ho. What do we have up here? Try to take the high ground again. Ooh, bloodstone. That's pretty neat. Embrium. What do I see? What do I see? I see bad guys. A Freeman sniper. Alright, I'll show you what a sniper is. Alright, so we go 5. And we go 4. And we go 1, 2. That's what a real sniper does, people. Takes them out. Real sniper. Ooh, a captain. Hey, how come I keep losing target? Look at that. I love it how the loot just magically appears at my feet when it's too far away. Alright, I'm not liking the looks of Iron Bowl down so low. We had some bad guys there. There's going to be more bad guys down here. You just watch. See? Bad guys. Oh. Alright. So that's good. 5, 4. Take out another sniper. See, that's how you do it, people. That's how you take out a sniper. Oops. I guess I need to come in a little closer. Get a little high up. Alright, we got another sniper. Whoops, that wasn't what I wanted. This is what I wanted. Okay. So... he's knocked out. Let's switch to Vivienne. And then what's this down here? I forget. Fade Cloak. Resurgence. Take a rearing potion. Alright, we'll target him. And then we'll come down here. So I guess we need to go to the villa. See, with every hit, she builds her... there you go, Iron Bow. Alright. Oops. I guess she needs to take some. There we go.
This is the people troubling those cave rats.
Alright. Glitting Dermalon. Ooh, I think we know somebody who might like that. Right, Iron Bull? Fade Touched Ring Velvet, that's good stuff. Alright, so let's take a look here. Weapons, two-handed. Gee, I wonder which one I should use. Except for he's not quite there yet. Eh, it's not worth it. We'll just stick with that, and then when he levels up. Alright, so we're down to 8. Alright, I think what we're going to do, whoops, is we'll check out that. We're not going to go in here quite yet. think what we're going to do is... Can I claim this thing? Nope. Oh, that's the thing I could claim. Go back down there. Well, there's the statue. Claim the statue. Search that building, and then the other building that we first came upon. Replenish our healing potions, because we're down to 8 out of 12, and we got two guys that are halfway low on health. Dwarven axe. Wow. That's pretty nice, too. Staff of Flares, wide greatsword grip. August has made progress in the Exalted Plains. We are together in this, but Maker's Breath, how he irks me. That weapon, or whatever secret is hidden in those glyphs, is mine by rights. Maleficent trusts me most. Bah, he won't have it. Not while I live. Okay. Oops, we got a bag of something over here. Phoenix scales, that's good. Alright, what else we got? A little book with some flowers, that's cute. Harden Hightown. Okay. I'll do this. Okay, now we're coming around this way. Hop. Oh, we got something up here. Loot. Oh, that must be from that sniper. Ring velvet. Common cloth is okay. Alright, I think we gotta go back up here. Yeah, I wanna check out that building here. That's the first building we came upon. Oh, if only we had a thief who could pick this lock. Dum dum dum. Shipments are prepared, and once again, the rats from Watcher's Reach are getting in my way. One woman got far enough into my camp to look in the crates, scrounging for food, no doubt. Sneaky little peasants. Perhaps traps next time. All right. Ferelden Broadaxe. Sacrificial Dagger, that's kind of nice schematic there if we had a dual-wield scout. Alright, so I think that's pretty much it, except for going into the villa itself. But I'm down to half my health, so I think what I'm going to do is head back to camp. Which replenishes my health and potions. And then... How's my inventory doing? Only half full. Okay. So then I can fast travel back to here. And then I can head north again.
This war has gone on too long.
Don't look for trouble.
Oh, I don't have to look for it, buddy. It finds me. I was really hoping I could establish another camp up here, but it looks like I need to adventure in the villa first. Kind of a pretty area. Lots of greenery. Okay, I got the key from the body. Villa Morial.
Freeman's leader should be holed up here. This place has seen better days.
Do you expect cleanliness from a group of thugs, Inquisitor?
Is that too much to ask? Tidy up about yourself, even if you are a thug? I mean, come on. Alright, so we had a lot of talking in this episode getting into here, so I'm going to go ahead and end this now. And we will start... Where are we at here? Noise, Emerald Graves. Expand. We're working on a corrupt general. Yes, we're working with on a corrupt general quest. So we have to deal with Malefant. We'll do that in the next episode. So I appreciate you watching. If you like it, give me a like. Go ahead and leave a comment. Tell all your friends, whatever. And I'll see you next time.